Webster's word of the year for 2017 is feminism. But what does it really mean? I mean, is it the showboating sort of virtue signaling that in effect panders and I think patronizes women? I can think of one politician who exemplifies that description. After all, that act is so 2016. While it's complicated, I think it's fair to summarize the big debate on feminism centers on what are called second-wave feminists like Camille Paglia, Kathy Young, Christina Hoff Sommers, who have worked tirelessly for women's equality, like equality of opportunity, mutual respect between the sexes. But no way do they see women as victims or oppressed in Western society, which is a common characteristic of what's been called third-wave feminism that dominates university campuses. Wave 2 feminists like Christina Sommers are not on board with the campus feminists who, to not put too fine a point on it, blame men, hate men. She calls them the fainting couch feminists, who recoil from daily microaggressions and are in need of safe spaces. And by the way, this is an ugly division, as Ms. Sommer obliterates many of the victim-driven stats regarding women like the wage gap. More recently, with the hashtag MeToo movement, a New York Times piece, this week by author Daphne Merkin, joins second-wave feminists in bemoaning turning a bona fide moment of moral accountability but into a series of ad hoc and sometimes unproven accusations that suggest that all women are victims. That's the key component here. In this clip, for instant wisdom, Christina Hoff Sommers, who, by the way, is a resident scholar at the American Enterprise Institute, former philosophy professor, author of Who Stole Feminism, host of The Factual Feminists on YouTube, describes in an interview with Dave Rubin how this new form of feminism grew.
I will tell you what I know best is among the feminists is a small group in the universities gain control of the knowledge base. I mean, what we think we know about men and women. So you're a journalist and you need to know something about the wage gap, or you need to know something about women and in education. You go to these people, and they are what the journalist doesn't know, or the politician or the interested party doesn't know, is that they're spinning. And they have an ideology that drives their research. Mm-hmm. So I think a lot of people don't realize that there's so much spurious scholarship. So they take it seriously. And now there are untruths, exaggerations, factoids that have been repeated so often they're almost beyond the reach of rational analysis. And if you question them, you are by definition a sexist or worse. So they got a certain amount of power just through this information, this scholarship about how, in this case, about how oppressed women were.
Yeah.
So you have to sympathize, and then they then kind of went off the deep end with this psychobabble and these psychodramas about I'm triggered, and at Brown University. This is a year or so ago, and there was a story about it. You may have seen it. I'm sure you did, in the New York Times by Judith Shulevitz. At Brown University, they had a debate. So it was two feminists, actually, a libertarian feminist and someone else, another feminist, debating rape statistics. And you would think that's perfect. What more could the students want? They can hear both sides, and their side's well represented. No, they didn't want the debate at all, and they formed a safe room. And in that safe room, they were playing tapes of frolicking puppy dogs. They had bubbles, coloring books, Play-Doh. Maybe I made up the Play-Doh. No, I think they had Play-Doh.
It was probably there.
It was really there.
Yeah.
So this is so infantilizing. And again, I and many other feminists of my generation look at it and think, this is infantilization. This is the opposite of what feminism should be. And when I got to college, we threw out the dorm counselors and the guardians of our virtue and all that. We wanted to be in charge.
That's Christina Hoff Sommers. As I say, this is a very hot debate, very prominent debate in the U.S. especially, it seems, brought on further by the Me Too movement, but obviously very important debate as we've gone through the last several years. But there is a huge division, as I alluded to, between second-wave feminists and the new feminists that dominate university campuses. I'm sure we're going to hear a lot more about that.